Hey everybody, this is Jeff Posnick from the YouTube Developer Relations team, and we're continuing a series of videos talking about the migration that developers might have from going from version 2 of the YouTube Data API to version 3. We strongly encourage all developers to start that migration if they haven't done so yet. And today we're going to be talking about a way of subscribing to a user's channel and show how that's changed between version 2 and version 3 of the API. So let's first talk a little bit about how you would subscribe to a given YouTube channel in version 2 of the API. And I just have a page in the documentation up here to just give an overview for folks who aren't familiar. This is the actual RESTful API call that you would use in version 2. You know, everything, again, is Atom XML based, so you have this pretty big XML document that you would pass in a post request that's been authenticated, obviously. And you know, this will end up subscribing to a given channel. So, you know, that does work, but let's talk about how you would do that in the more modern version 3 of the YouTube Data API. So, to start, in version 3, we operate on channel IDs rather than legacy usernames. And this is particularly important because there are not legacy usernames for every given YouTube channel. There are channels out there that just have channel IDs associated with them. So using a channel ID consistently throughout version 3 of the API means you could deal the exact same way with any type of channel, even these newer channels that don't have legacy usernames. But that also means that if we do have a channel and we know what the legacy username is, we need to first translate that legacy username into a channel ID. So let's do that using the V3 API call youtube.channels.list. I'm going to show an example of making this API call from within the API Explorer, which is just a web-based harness for making API calls and just kind of simplifies things. It's a great way to play around with the API before you actually start writing code using our client libraries. If you wanted to just experiment with what different API parameters do, really highly encourage that you check it out. So in this particular case, we want to translate a username into a channel ID. So in V3, there's this concept of a part parameter that most of our operations take. And I'm going to say, in this particular case, I want the ID part returned. Think of this as a way of kind of limiting the response that you get back from the API so that it only contains the information that you specifically ask for. Instead of receiving, you know, a really large document that has all the details about a channel, I'm saying here all I want back is the ID. So this is going to result in fast response. It's great for, you know, contexts where you might have limited bandwidth or, you know, just don't want to deal with processing a whole big response document. So I'm going to say I want the ID, and the channel that I want the ID for is Google Developers. It's kind of our standard subscription channel. And I'm going to go down here, and I'm going to click Execute. This is making the V3 API call for me. And I'm going to get back this very small response in JSON, and it contains this ID value. So let me copy that, and I'm going to use it in my next API call. And the actual way of inserting a subscription in V3 of the API is with a youtube.subscriptions.insert call. I have here the documentation for that particular API call. If you haven't looked through the V3 API documentation yet, I'd recommend that you pour through it a little bit. It looks a little daunting in that there's a whole bunch of different kind of methods listed over here on the left-hand side that you navigate through, but I think you'll find that all of the methods follow a very, very consistent interface and naming conventions that are used throughout. And once you kind of get familiar with making API calls against one particular service, using methods in other services should become second nature. So hopefully you'll find it's a really consistent API. So again, in this particular case, I have the documentation for the subscriptions insert method open. And you'll learn a little bit more about what the different parameters are. And you'll learn about what you could set in the request body when you're making your YouTube API V3 request. In this particular case, it's saying that I need to specify something for snippet.resource ID. And one of the other nice things about the V3 documentation is that we have these live snippets of code that demonstrate how to make the API call using the client library selected over here. So you know, Java, PHP, Python, and Ruby for this particular API call. So if you were doing Python code, for instance, you could pretty much just copy this and do it straight away without having to change too much. But I want to show how you would make that API call in a little bit more of an agnostic way. So we have pretty much the equivalent of this other page, this API Explorer, embedded inline in our documentation at the very bottom of this page. And it's going to allow me to make this API call. And the other nice thing that it allows me to do is go through the OAuth2 flow for authorizing access to my particular channel. It has to know, you know, who I am before it'll let me subscribe to a given channel. So this simplifies things for testing purposes. I'm just going to click authorize down here. When you're writing your own code, you're going to want to you know, make use of your own OAuth2 registration. We have some other training material out there that kind of talks you through the whole process of getting up to speed with OAuth2. But for these purposes, we could just test using that. And I'm going to put in part equals snippet because I know from reading up here that I need to set a value for snippet.resourceID. So this is kind of my way for an insert. Even though this is doing an insert call, it's saying what fields I'm going to be setting in the request body. And this API Explorer has a really nice interface over here for just choosing what I'm setting in the request body. It's a way of kind of like programmatically building up my request body for me. Again, if you're writing real code, you're going to be probably using client library. There's going to be equivalents of doing this in each client library and refer to our documentation. You could also refer to github.com/YouTube, where we have all these examples that are inline in the docs. You know, we have kind of a standalone version there. So check that out. But for illustrative purposes, I'm going to just do this over here. So I'm setting snippet resource ID channel ID, and I'm going to be pasting in the channel ID that I got from the previous call. And I'm going to click execute. And at this point, I will have a subscription to that channel. So that's great. It just gives me some information about the channel that I just subscribed to over here in the response. And looks like everything worked as expected. So that gives you an example of how you could make a YouTube Data API version 3 subscription insertion. I think that once you get familiar with that basic way of doing subscription insertions, you'll find that things like inserting a new playlist or adding items to a playlist or doing a number of other operations all follow the very same principle. And you know, hopefully it'll be a straightforward migration for you, moving your code from V2 to the V3 equivalent. So thanks very much for taking the time to watch this. Again, I'm Jeff Posnick from the YouTube Developer Relations team, and happy migrating.